All right, guys, before I bleed out any more students, let's try some of these. So when it says simplify, it really just means reduce. There is one problem up here I disagree with. It's a decimal already, so this one I would just take to a unit. Right, it comes out nice anyway. So how do you reduce 56 over 32?
You can divide by 8. Yeah, you can divide by 8. So you get 7 over 4.
I like it. There were no units to worry about, so that's awesome. Yes, ma'am?
Why do you divide?
Because I have to. If you give me an answer, I don't care what chapter we're in. If you say the answer is 6 over 8, you will lose points. You got to be at the point where you understand this. Why would you lose points for giving me that answer? It's not reduced. There you go. So it said simplify. So if you don't simplify, that's obviously not doing what the direction said. You'll lose points. That should not be a surprise. Yes?
What if I like 1.95?
That'd be wrong because they didn't really ask.
Like the same answer, but like just divided 7, divided by 4.
I don't care. It didn't say give a unit rate. It said simplify.
Okay.
All right. And then over here, they do have units, but what do the units do? Over here for number 640. What is ounce divided by ounce? What do they do?
They
cancel. Because they're same on the top and bottom. So we did a problem like that before. If the units are the same, they cancel. It becomes just a multiplier. And now you reduce 64 over 30. All right, you can do by 2. Good. And then nothing else goes in there. Let me stop there. So the first couple were really just fraction problems. And I know that fractions still give my 281 students trouble, but you guys are going to be better than them. We've gone through our fraction section. They are going to keep coming up. Don't feel like, oh, they're done. We're done with fractions. No, we ain't. Here's some more examples of more fractions. This one is one I kind of disagree with them with.
Could you not simplify that?
What goes into both 32 and 15?
I mean, so you wouldn't write it.
You would never write it as a mixed number.
Okay.
Because then that loses the something per something.
Gotcha.
So you want to maintain that ratio. I like it. So this one I would just divide directly. Right? If you do this the long way, doing the calculator or whatever right now, I can't tell. But you should be able to do it the long way. What do you end up with?
17.
Yeah, 17.50 per
one.
I don't think they gave us any units on the bottom, right?
Hours?
Okay. So I can just put 17.50 per
hour.
Pretty good, right? All right, so since my first job was 3.25 an hour. $6.47. Yes, ma'am.
I have a question. Are we going to have to do any, 6.38? Or it's 1 and 3/4 to 1 and 5/8?
Yeah, we'll do one. I didn't even really look at that, but yeah, that's going
to
happen.
Yeah, that wasn't on their assignment. I just wanted to know if they're not.
Well, no, we'll do one, because you definitely will have to do that. Here you just divide again. If I do this the long way, I've got to move this over once, right? And then you start to tack it. So once, 75 minus equals 15, bring down the zero.
Two.
Yeah, 2. Like.
So
2 times that is 150, so that you're done. So it'll be 12, what?
12
pounds per
sugar.
Square inch. No sugar. I like that. If you've ever inflated your tire, you should be used to pounds per square inch, right? You do it too much and the tire's going to blow up in your face. I've seen some YouTube videos, it's horrible. All right. Yeah. So this one, I know at the beginning, is it going to be more or less than a buck per pen?
Less.
Less, because 11 twelfths is less than one. Now, if you do divide 12 into 11, it will eventually work. So 12 goes on 110.
Nine
times. That'll be 108. 20. So once. 12. 80.
One, six.
Yeah, so this will be
6.
72. 80. So then they're just going to keep going with 80, aren't you? I mean, you know, there's a place you know to stop.
Yeah.
So 6666 forever.
Yeah.
So now it'll be 0.916 repeating per pen. So just under 92 cents a pen. Do you guys see how I can interpret that? Just under 92 cents. Per pen. If you want to put the one there, you can, but you obviously don't have to. It's understood to be one. Yes, ma'am?
Never
mind. I can do that. And then 654 is the unit price, so you can compare the two. All right, so what do you get when you divide? What was it, 12 what's?
Ounces.
So you divide 429 by 12, what do you get? 3, 6, 3, 5. Oh, is it 35 cents? Is it going evenly? No, it can't be. 357, all right, I was close. $0.357 per ounce. Now, please, dear God, hear me now. You don't put dollars, you don't put ounces, you lose a point. Because part of the answer is the units. If one is per ounce, the other is per pound, well, that's not fair. You want to make sure that everybody understands it's the same units. Here, when you divide 729 by 22, what do you get? 331. Something like that. Sounds right.
I think I finished.
So obviously, which one's the better price?
The bottom.
This time it's the bigger bottle, right? Cool. It won't always be. So you can just circle that. Make it really clear which one is the better buy. If you just do this work and never show me which one's the better buy, you didn't really give me an answer, right? I'm trying to save you from silly mistakes that you can make. Okay, last thing for today. Oh, sorry, I was going to do one example like, let's do number 638. Let's do that one. Has everybody got this here? If you want it, has everybody got that? You're not going to let me know? Okay. Just race and see if anybody yelps. Wait! Love this problem. I would. So real quick, if I said M to B, how'd you write that as a ratio?
M over B.
Oh, you know what the hell M and B are, and you knew how to write it as a ratio. So here, I gave you numbers. You write it as a ratio the exact same way. The process never gives a shit about what's actually in there. There's a process. You write the 2 tells you where the line goes. 1 3/4 on the top. 1 5/8 on the bottom. Now what the hell?
Mixed number.
Yeah, so and then you want to make it into?
Improper fraction.
Improper fraction. I like that. All right. So you get?
7/4.
13/8. Yeah, it's 13/8. And then this says 7/4 divided by 13/8. 7/4 times
8/13.
8/13. Real quick, does it make sense? The answer is bigger than 1, because the top is bigger than the bottom. 1 3/4 would be 1 6/8. So the top is a little bigger than the bottom, therefore the answer should come out to be bigger than 1. Please let that make sense. Did you have to notice that to do this problem? No. But it's just making sense of the problem. Why did the answer come out to be bigger than 1? Because of that. The top was bigger than 1 to begin with. Bigger than the bottom to begin with is what I should say. Is that cool? So that's how you do those. Yeah. So the ratio, and then you attack it with the stuff we know, make it into mixed numbers. We know how to attack those kind of problems. Okay, so last thing for today. So we're hanging in there, you guys. Gotta have stamina to get through. Where are we at? 5-7. I don't think we've talked about this at all yet, but let me see how much you already know about these things. So let me know the square root of 25.
5.
Why?
Five times five.
No. Because 5 times 5 is 25. The question that the square root asks you, and this is the thing about math. Whenever you get a new symbol, like that square root symbol is a freaky-ass symbol. There's a big history about why it looks that way. It didn't used to look that way. This is a simplified version of what it used to be.
Thank God.
You just have to know what the question is that it represents. Math is shorthand. So we use a single a symbol to represent a whole question. So what is that asking you? It's asking you, what does it take 2 of to multiply to be this? And of course it takes 2 fives to multiply to be 25. That's why the answer is 5. I like it. So what's the square root of 64?
8.
Because?
8 times 8
or 8 squared, 64. So the square root is the opposite of squares. You guys with me? A little bit? So the minute you know what the question is, that's what you say to yourself when you see it, and then you do what you just said to yourself. So how would you do this? What, Jeff? I don't know, man. You can do it, man. Let's do, yeah. So one way is just to guess until you can do it. Now what if I gave this to you on the part of the test that you're not allowed to use calculators? Ooh, Jeff, what the shit.
It would take a long time.
2 divided.
Wait, no one say 98.
Huh? What about 98?
98.
All right, now watch. I like it. Now watch, guys. 25 is 5 times 5. Did I have to do that? No, I kind of knew that. 64 is 8 times 8. Did I have to do that? No, I kind of knew that. 196 is what time? I don't know. So I want to give you a way. So if I start to break it down, and a good thing to notice is it's even. So 2 goes in. 2 times?
19.
2 times 19 is not 196. 2 times 8 is not 196. What's happening right now?
So,
98. Alright. And then 2 times what is 98?
49.
And then what times itself is 49?
49.
7 times 7.
Now watch, you guys ready? Stay with me. So isn't 2 times 7 14? Isn't 2 times 7 14? So the square root of 196 is 14 because it's made up of 1, 2, 14. So that's the way you could attack a problem that's a little bit bigger than you're used to. You can kind of break it down to see what it's made of. Because what are square roots all about? What is it made of? 2 things that are the same thing. So if I get a big-ass number, I can start to break it down, see what the hell it's made of. Otherwise, you'll just get numbers that you should already know. What's the square root of 1? 1. What's the square root of 121? 11. I like it. 11's neat. 11 cubed is 1331. 1331. It's got a neat pattern. That's all I'll say about it. All right, so here's That's all I'll say about that 11. Don't tack all the way up yet. Now, just to push this a little bit, just to show you two things. What would this be?
No.
2 times 2 is? So that's not the answer. What's the question? What does it take 2 of to multiply be negative 4? So 2 can't be the answer. There's no answer. 11. Because the answer can't be 2, because 2 times 2 is 4. The answer can't be negative 2, because negative 2 times negative 2 is?
Positive 4.
4. So there is no single real number that multiplies by itself to be negative 4. So I would say this is not real.
Error.
No, because it's telling me you got out of your calculator. Error or real whoppers. No, I don't want any of that shit. Yeah, let me give you this one. What's the square root of 0.09?
0.03?
Nope. As if you thought it was 0.03 and you check yourself, 0.03 times 0.03 is 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh shit, 1, 2, 3. Oh man, that's way too many. It's not 0.03, it's 0.3. Because 0.3 times 0.3 is 9, 1, 2. 1, 2, bam. I like it. And again, you don't have to know the answer right off the bat. You have to know what to think about. What do you think about? What do you multiply by itself to make that number inside? That's how you kind of work it. You're not supposed to just look at it and know all the time. I know you get into that and I say, what's the square root of 49? And you guys say 7. You've got start to feel like everything should be that way. Well, you know the better than that. It ain't always going to be bam, bam. This is that. No, you got to know what the hell this is asking you for. So you have a way to attack it. Don't feel like, well, that took longer than 3 seconds. Let me go to the next one. That's insane. All right. Last thing. Does anybody know what number is known to be sitting right here that we don't write? There's a little 2 known to be sitting right there because it's a square root. A little 2 tells you what does it take 2 of to make the inside. So if I saw this, I'm going a little further than the book, because the book don't go far enough. What does it take 3 of to multiply to be like 8?
2.
So the cube root of 8 is 2 because 2 times 2 times 2 is 8.
The what of 8? What's it called?
Cube root. Isn't this a cube power? So this is a cube root. This is a squared power. This is a square root. Bam, they go together because one is the opposite of the other one. Since 2 cubed is 8, the cube root of 8 brings me back to 2. So you do 4th root, 5th root, you go insane. We're obviously not going to go. In fact, I don't think this book goes beyond square roots. No. So that was just me being crazy and showing you a little bit more. Now they do this. What do you think about this? You're like, I don't know, Jeff. You haven't put it up there yet. Yeah, so they're going to say assume all variables are bigger than 0, and they have to say that. But don't worry about it. But you're basically thinking the same thing. What does it take 2 of to multiply the x squared? Obviously, it takes 2 x's. Why is the square root of x squared x? Because x times x is x squared. So what's the cube root of x cubed? Freaking x. Yeah. All right. So what do you think the square root of x to the 4th is? X squared. I like it. Because x squared times x squared is x to the 4th. But you see how the idea doesn't give a shit what's in there. The idea doesn't give a shit what number's there. It's how, what does it take this many of to multiply to be this? That's the idea. And then every single problem involving radicals, you attack it with that idea. I like it. Cool. Yes, sir?
If we take a minus before the...
Oh, yeah. All right. So, yeah, if you had this... So you can't do this. That's no good.
No.
But what's this? Well, that's going to be... Square root of 4 is... What's the square root of 4? 2, because 2 times 2 is 4. So that's negative 2. I like it. And last one, very last problem. That you could do.
No.
Yes, you can. So think about, how do you make 27? What do you multiply by itself 3 times to make 27? Not 9. 9 times 9 is 81. Sorry, 2. 3. But to make it negative 27,
negative.
So what's negative 3 times negative 3? What's negative 3 times negative 3? 9. Times another negative 3? Negative 27. So it takes 3 negative 3s, so multiply by negative 27.
So basically you just do the problem and attack negative 1.
Yes, but notice how odd roots are cool with negatives,
right?
While even roots aren't. Because any two negatives will do what to each other? Kill each other. So if there's still a negative on it, it freaks out. But what will three negatives do? Two of them kill each other and one's left alive. So that's why an odd root can handle negatives. It's fine with it. This guy's like, how the hell did you come up to be? I don't know what the hell to do with you. But a cube root or a fifth root or whatever, they're like, no problem. All right, that's enough. You guys look completely oppressed. I'm sorry.
That's plenty.
So you guys can look ahead into chapter 6. It's going to be all about percentages, finally. We talk about fractions, decimals, percentages, definitely next.
What's
up? Yeah.